Hello viewers, welcome to Elim TV, a station where you watch and learn. Your tutor is Mr. Wanyoike, an agriculture teacher. In today's lesson, we are in Form 1, Lesson 13, and the topic, we are on topic of factors influencing agriculture, and subtopic, we are on physical properties of soil. Lesson objectives, by the end of this lesson, you should be able to number 1, state 3 classification of soil based on physical properties. And number 2, explain soil classification based on chemical properties. We are going to start with classification of soil. The soil can be classified based on physical and chemical properties. And on the first classification, that is on soil classification based on physical properties, we have 3 aspects that are normally used. We normally use the soil color, the soil texture, and finally, we normally classify soil physically using soil structure. And effect of soil color. The dark colored soil, as you can see, they are well illustrated here. There is clay soil, which is very dark. Then there is silt, which is kind of brown. And there is sand, which is not as dark as compared to clay. The clay soil is a good absorber of water, and also it is a good absorber of heat. And therefore, dark colored soil normally absorb a lot of heat and also retain a lot of heat. And these will influence the way the microbes are functioning in the soil. Because by absorbing heat and retaining this heat, it will increase the microbial activity in the soil. And therefore, these soils become highly productive because the microorganisms are very, very active. And for instance, the nitrogen-fixing bacteria, the decomposers, once they are very active, it means that the crop production will also improve. Then we have light-colored soil. On the other hand, the light-colored soil, the microorganisms are less active. Why? Because the temperatures are not conducive for their activities. And you can see in this diagram, there is some carrots which have been grown there. And the soil, as you can see, it is very dark. And these carrots are very healthy. Why? Because of the aspect of the soil being dull or dark, it absorbs the heat, increasing the microbial activity in the soil. That is, these are the decomposers and also the nitrogen-fixing bacteria. And therefore, it will help these plants to obtain nutrients, because by decomposers affecting decomposition, the organic matter will be broken down, thus releasing nutrients into the soil for plant use. And that's why these carrots look very, very healthy. Then we have effect of soil texture. We have soil texture determine, number 1, rate of water absorption. Number 2, rate at which soil water hold the water, that is the soil water holding capacity. Number 3, drainage. And number 4, soil aeration. I will demonstrate the same with the different types of soils. Here on my diagrams here, I have clay soil. In the first upper 2 diagrams, we have clay soil. When it is very hot, it normally cracks. Yeah, and when it is when it is wet, it holds a lot of water, and it retains this water for a very long period of time. And therefore, clay soil has a good water holding capacity, and also it is a good absorber of water, and therefore it retains water for a long period of time, thus providing enough moisture to the crop which are grown in these particular soils. Then we have the drainage and soil aeration. On the bottom diagram, there is a kind of a desert here, or a semi-arid region. And you can see that the area is occupied with a lot of sand, and sands are poorly drained, and also they are well aerated. And this means that this soil, because they are well aerated and well drained, it means that when it is very hot, the rate at which the water will be lost will be also be very high, and this reduces the moisture content, and this will affect the growth of crop because they will retain less amount of water. Then we go to the types of soil based on soil texture. As I said, we have clay soil. It is contained very fine soil particles. Then we have sandy soil. It has coarse soil material. Then we have the gravel, and finally we have loam, which is medium-sized soil particles. Then we can go to the second classification of soil properties. It is based on chemical properties, and on chemical properties, the only chemical properties that is used to classify soil is the soil pH. And what is the soil pH? The P stand for power or potential, and the H means for hydrogen. So pH, the initials stand for potential for hydrogen. And by definition, we can define soil pH as the level of alkalinity or acidity of a given sample of soil. And under this category, we can classify a soil into three categories. We have acidic soil, neutral soil, and finally we have basic soil. Acidic soil are the soils that normally have a pH of less than 7. And those soils that have a pH of 7, they are referred to as neutral soil. On the other hand, those soils that have a pH of more than 7 to 14, that is, they are referred to as basic or alkaline soils. Then we will wind up the lesson by giving you some questions to gauge whether you have understood or whether you have followed the lesson. And the first question is, state any three physical properties used to classify soil. And the second activity, question number two, state the chemical properties used to classify the soil. And you can refer from the book, that is Secondary Agriculture, Student Book 1, that edition, and the publisher is the KLLB, or Kenya Literature Bureau. For more information, or for more clarification, you can reach us through the following addresses. We are on Elimu TV. You can use the SMS using that number, which is well displayed. Then you can also reach us through YouTube at Elimu TV. Then you can also reach us through Facebook platform at Elimu TV. And finally, you can reach us through Twitter. You can tweet us at Elimu_TV_KE. And therefore, I thank you for watching me in this lesson, and I hope you will stay tuned to Elimu TV, which is a station which enlightens all types of people.